Okay, jo. So. It seems like my positioning of the player might work now. Yesterday I had some issues with it, but now the initial line of the player seems to be at the right location now. So. Okay. The stack frame seems to work. Not too good. Okay. Move. Word. To be X. This looks surprisingly nice, but it's wrong. Oh. Okay. Fucking shit. Why does it look like this? Okay, maybe this whole stack thing is not the way to go. Okay. Hello there, by the way. Oh, I mistyped. For now. Ah, okay. I can finally write the first line of the player pedal for my Pong clone at the right location. But now I have to figure out how I can write all these different lines. So the pedal is actually some sort of rectangle instead of of just one single line. Yeah, but I haven't figured it out yet. I mean, I'm supposed to make some sort of loop, but this looping doesn't work yet. And this bottle is not a wine bottle, it's just water, so you don't need to worry. So, okay. Okay. Hmm. How do I add this? It's pretty sad that I have to use some actual memory instead of relying on registers. But this multiplication uses the DX register, so I can't actually use it, even if it's not explicitly called. But just gets changed after the multiplication. So I could use it for storing the y. No, I can't really use it for storing the I value. I mean, I would need to load the I value each time. It's not too easy. Writing the frame buffer offset. Set it. If I make a word out of it, then I need to change some things. Okay, it assembles without any error, and yeah. Okay. What happens? I change the value of this. Okay, now it's on the first row, line. Oh god, confusing. No. Doesn't affect anything yet. Why? I can use any register which I want. I'm supposed to be able to use one byte and add it to a 2-byte register. But somehow, this doesn't really happen. Hello. The y value. And if I add the I value, then nothing happens. Not too good. If I increase it, then probably still nothing happens. No. Ah, of course, of course. Of course, nothing would happen because I write 0 into this memory location. Something in here, then something should actually change. And it changes. Awesome. Awesome. Okay, then I write 0 again. Okay, so the code actually seems to work. So, how do I loop now? Store it again in memory. Not yet. Okay. Store it. I need to compare AX with player hide and jump jump less. Player draw loop. Okay. Oh, great! It's an actual rectangle now. I mean, there's still some small bug. I don't know. I'm not sure if you can see it, but there's one pixel that is apparently off. But it's a rectangle, more or less. So, okay. But why does it draw this additional pixel? Yeah. incrementing counting variable. Okay. Yeah, now I can finally see that actual C code is way easier to read. I mean, I used to write some more assembly code almost a decade ago when I was in my youth. So I actually need some time to readjust again. But yeah, but apparently I can figure it out and somewhat works, and it's always pretty nice to see how things work under the hood. So if you're programming in C or even C++, you can actually see what your compiler does if you write some assembly code on your own. And I feel so awkward drinking with this out of this wine bottle, even if it's just water. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so how big is the image now? Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so these are 16 bytes. 16, 32, 48, 64, 80. Okay, so I use about 81 bytes now. Okay, so I have something like 400 bytes left available. Okay. And does this halt function actually do something? I'm not sure. Jump. Stop. Okay. Stop. Okay. So then I won't rely on this halt function, as I'm not sure if it actually works as intended. Ah, okay. And yeah, and now I can see. Oh, okay. Now I can see this one weird pixel is gone, because apparently this halt instruction doesn't really work as intended. Okay. But it's probably not the most beautiful solution to have an infinite loop. okay.
Okay.
Okay, a small commit. Now there's some actual easy stuff to do. Determining the intended size of the player pedal or the player rectangle. And as I have a resolution of 320 by 200, which is interesting because you wouldn't expect such a thing anymore nowadays because of the aspect ratio. So, okay, but okay, if I have view, foot control alt F. Okay, so it would look like this if you would actually boot it up on a machine. It's too big. No question. This might actually be fine. But I would still assume it's a little bit too wide. The height seems fine to me. But I make it a little bit smaller, or narrow. Ah, that's good. Now it's just 6 pixels wide. 6 pixels. How to continue? I would still need a second pedal for the enemy player, and I need this kind of ball or whatever it is, which gets thrown around in Pong, and then I would need some sort of input and I would need to synchronize everything to some kind of clock, because currently the CPU does everything as fast as possible, which is not always what you want to have in a game. And it would be awesome if I could actually make some sort of function out of this player drawing functionality. It would be a waste if I would need to copy everything. Okay. How are these? Okay. No. yeah, I can make some macro out of it. I'm not sure. It's not actually beautiful, because I would kind of copy the code, even if it's in a somewhat more readable form than simply copying it. Draw player one. And make sure. Okay. Boom. Okay. We can copy this into the macro. Okay. It looks okay. 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 Then draw player one. Do we still get the same result? We do. If I remove it, then we hopefully get some sort of different result. Yeah, a simple black screen. Okay. Then we let it return. Okay. Then we'll make another macro for the second player pedal. I don't want to make some AI enemy, because I'm not sure if it's easier to do. It's probably easier to have a second player actually controlling the second pedal. So, okay. And we'll copy this macro. I haven't used these macros and NASM back in the past, so I'm not really familiar with them, but I assume you can do some sort of macro assembly programming, which is almost like, yeah, kind of regular programming, because you can pass in some sorts of parameters. Okay, okay, what do we change? Okay, when we call this, we can use the I variable again. We need to change, we need to make some variables. Okay, player one X, player one Y, player two X, player two Y. Oh no. Now the size increases. Okay, play up. Okay. Okay, this is all we need. Okay. Okay, where do we place the second pedal? That's something like 300. No, yeah, 290 pixels, and place it here. Okay. Well. Okay. We need to change some names. Player one, draw loop. Player one, draw loop. Player two, draw loop. And player two draw loop. This should do it. Ooh, now it actually looks like something. I mean, they can't move yet. They can't move yet, but at least it already looks like something. How do I get? What do we know about the size? Okay. Yeah. These are the two last bytes of the first sector of this floppy disk image, which I create within NASM. So with this 55AA, these are the these are the magic numbers for the BIOS when it reads the first sector, and if it can read these two bytes with the hex values 55 and AA, then it knows this is supposed to be some sort of boot sector instead of just some storage, and it reads the boot sector and executes it basically. And as it looks, a little bit more than a quarter of available space is filled now, maybe even something like 30%. So everything that is not 0000 is basically filled with code and data from my program so far. Okay, but but anyway, I'm already quite happy that we have these two pedals now. Now it would actually be awesome to be able to move them, and first I think I have to actually synchronize the main loop with some sort of clock. I'm not sure how this whole clock thing works with the BIOS. BIOS clock real mode. Okay. Yeah, BIOS clock remote assembly, maybe. Writing bootable stuff. Yeah. Anyway, it seems to be nice that we are beyond this regular bootloader tutorial stuff. I mean, you can see how you can boot something and at which location something gets loaded into the memory, which is why I need this ORG 7C00, because this is the memory address of the executable code within the real RAM. And yeah, okay. Yeah, this is the number which I told you about a little bit earlier, and this is to actually make a whole floppy disk image with these famous 1.44 megabytes of storage. So we basically fill up the memory with zeros up to this point, so we get a whole floppy disk image. Yeah, but how does this clock thing work? I think there's I'm not sure. I read something about an interrupt that gets called something like 18.2 times per second. BIOS timer interrupt. But I'm not sure if this gets executed or if I have to call it myself, and I have to find some information about it. Ah, yeah. Okay, real-time clock interrupt. Real-time. x86. Ah, real-time, okay. QA. I'm not sure if I like this whole C notation thing. I mean, you can kind of see what is. Oh wow! You can kind of see. You can kind of see what is going on. But at the same time, you always have to translate it into assembly code. I'm not sure. Is it within real mode or is it already protected mode? Ooh, nice. Can I simply read it? Ah, no. I could read it, but the precision is not high enough. It's just a precision with, yeah, 1 second basically. 1 second precision. Oh, boom, 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 boom. No. Sentry register. Yay. Hardware clocks in. Okay. Now it's a little bit weird maybe, because I'm reading this German article, which is not an issue for me because I'm German, but it might be a little bit weird for someone watching the stream. Okay. I'm not sure if I actually want to write an interrupt handler. It seems like this would be some sort of overkill. Maybe I go on GitHub, and I think there are some Bootsector games, and maybe I Bootsector game. Chrome's T-Rex base. Ah, okay. Not with 80. Okay. interesting, but there needs to be but there needs to be some sort of time management, so to say. Okay, so he's doing it the same way as I do. Well, okay, he's actually writing some sort of score. Okay. Hey, where is he getting his time from? Or is he just using CPU cycles? I mean, this would be the easiest way to do, but this would result in a game that changes its speed depending on clock speed of the CPU. And this is something that you usually want to avoid, but with something like this, it's probably not a big issue. But even then, I would need some sort of rough estimate of how fast this CPU that is running is, and how many CPU cycles I need to run this code on most machines. But this would make it in some way platform dependent. But I would pause one moment because I need some small bathroom break, but I'll be back in a moment. So, see you around soon. I won't close the stream this time. Okay.
Streams, yeah. And I think that's kind of, 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 k
Device. Oh. Oh, makes more sense. I have to check my audio. Okay, great. So, okay, I'm back, I would say. And I show you how the game looks right now. It looks like this. Oh, it's not open. Okay. And so, back. So, okay, now I'm finally back. I had to take care of some injury at my finger. So, okay. Back to programming. I still need to create this clock. Yeah, and I was thinking about making it CPU dependent or CPU speed dependent. Which is not the most beautiful solution, but it would work, at least with modern CPUs, and luckily the CPU clock speeds haven't been changing too drastically. Okay. So, but let's read the code of this guy. How he handles time. Checking the timer. I'm not sure where this enemy timer be. Okay, random pixel. Ten. Oh, that's interesting. So he's actually having more than these 512 bytes. At least something like 10 bytes more, maybe. Yeah. So he's cheating in a way. Okay, and but I still don't know how he handles time. Timer. Enemy timer max. Okay. And I had this other idea that I might actually update things only when I get some input. No, it's not good. I mean, if you would play the game the whole time, then it would be okay. But if you would leave the keyboard alone for just one moment, the game would simply freeze. No, so this is not the way to go. Okay. Okay, interesting. Interesting. I think I found something. Okay. I'm just not sure if this is an actual BIOS interrupt or DOS interrupt. I can't use DOS interrupts.
Okay.
Yeah, so it seems to be this one. Now it's somewhat annoying because I can't really get the output, so I have to trust that it works because I'm working in this graphics mode. Maybe I can make some changes according to the time or something. Move. Okay. Annoying. Where is it? Oh. Okay. Yeah, so it seems to be this. It's gone. How many ticks? Ticks into. Yeah. If anyone has knowledge about these BIOS interrupts, I gladly take your wisdom. Okay, so this is these 18.2 clock ticks per second. Okay, this should do it. Okay, so the interesting value is inside dx, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, okay, so it's dx, okay. Okay, boom, 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 boom. Okay, so we need a new timer variable. Save it as a word. Okay. So it's move word timer begin dx. Okay. Then we can do something maybe. Reading of the timer, setting up timer. Oop, no. I hate that I accidentally delete stuff. So setting up timer. Variable. So, okay, now it should still work. Awesome. Hallo. Hallo. Ah. Ja, okay, shit. Ich dachte, der Ton müsste gehen. Das Mikrofon? Okay. Hallo. Hallo. Okay. Okay, it works. Okay. Yeah, I'm back now. I was just checking out my microphone, and apparently there's still some noise in the background, but you can hear me, I assume. So, okay. Back to how the game looks. The game currently looks like this. I'm working on some sort of clock now to update the screen regularly so it doesn't look weird, or sometimes you wouldn't be able to actually see something because the clear screen function takes up way more time than drawing these two pedals for the two players. Okay, so I just set up the initial timer, and so the timer increments every 55 each 55 milliseconds, if I'm not mistaken. And I just wrote the return value into this timer begin variable. Okay, what do I do? I need some some delay mechanism. Okay. Okay, timer. Ah, okay. Okay. For the next frame. And I'll luckily have this cute loop, which I can use for checking if there's a new tick, and after the new tick, I can continue with the execution of the new code in the loop. I don't know. Then I can continue the loop. Yeah, I can move it. Okay, yeah, I can compare memory with registers. Great. Dx, okay. Sync. Okay, then I'll change some variables just to see if it works. Okay, let's see if it works. It works! It actually works. I've got some movement going on. I'm not sure why I used the y, the x value, but it works! It works, it works, it works. Awesome. The real time clock works. Okay, great. So, okay, I think I'll create a new macro. Wait for a real-time clock, okay. fabrication. Okay, let's change the x to the y value and see what is happening. Then it should still work. Yeah, now it almost looks like some sort of pong. Whoa. Okay. Okay, let's make a commit. Okay. How much is of the available space is filled up? Okay, so it's around 1/3 of the available space. Something like 170 bytes. Okay. Great. Great, great, great. What's the next step now? Okay. I need some keyboard input, I would say, to actually be able to move. Yeah, the two player paddles, yeah, it would be great to actually be able to move them. And this bottle is still filled with water, so you don't need to worry. So, okay. Okay, keeping player on the screen. Okay. Okay, let's check for the lower end of the screen. Okay, it's res y, okay. There is some move conditional. I don't know, there are some conditional move instructions, but I'm not sure how they are called. Let's just type in conditional move assembly x86. Ah. Okay. Oh god. Okay. Below what? No. Above or equal? Okay. Above or equal. C move AE. Conditional move above or equal. I'm not sure if this works. Player height. I mean, these are defined constants, so it might actually work. I'm not sure. Move word player Y and from AX. Whoa, okay, now I don't need to purchase it right now. Oh, 106, okay. No, probably not. No, it still complains about N is. Define player lowest. Okay, now I have to calculate it. Where's the calculator? That's 320 minus, what is it, 32. Wow, okay, it's actually not that surprising. Okay, does it assemble now? No, it still doesn't assemble. I have to read from a memory address or a register? What? Okay. And does it stop now at the lower bottom of the screen? No, it doesn't stop. What? It kind of stops now? What does it do?